You're wrong, Lyric. They're not my weakness. They're my strength.
Okay, guys, what's up? It's C-Michael1997. I'm here to give you guys a review of Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric. So before I go into this review, I'm going to talk about the game itself. About Sonic itself, basically, because Sonic is getting a rise and a fall for the last 2 years, with some great games like Sonic Colors, Sonic Generations, and the Racing Series, and some bad games like Sonic the Hedgehog, Sonic and the Secret of Rings, Sonic and the Black Knight, and maybe Sonic and Leech to some point. But they have been getting a great rise, but then they stumped with Sonic Lost World due to some critics. And I really had a hope for Sonic Boom, due to the fact that for 2 reasons. One, it's the new design of it. And two, it's for the fact that it's not from Sonic Team. It's basically from Big Red Button, which is a former group of developers who worked on games like Crash Bandicoot, the Crash Bandicoot series, the Jak and Daxter series, and the first Uncharted. With a resume like that, you'd think that the game would have lots of great ideas behind it. And some of it was. Most only that each character have own diverse abilities and fighting skills. And I had hopes for that the entire way through. And the show is out already for a few weeks, and the game is now out. So does the game live up to it? Well, no. It doesn't. And this hurts me to say that, because I really did want Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric to be a great game. I want it to be one of those games that just grabbed me and just didn't let me go. Now, I'm going to answer a few questions at the exact same time. Because a lot of questions are the same. Austin Eller and basically Aaron Kaminsky ask, does it suck? Sometimes, yes. I am in Austin, so in other words, if you want this game to be great, amazing, you're not going to get that game with this. So there you go. That's the first question. And the second question is from Alan Chin. Does Sonic make out with a human girl? No. Sonic does not make out with a human girl. That's a good thing. If you guys not know, that happened in Sonic the Hedgehog 2006 at the end, like, so don't even ask me. I don't care. And I'm gonna ask a few questions before I start the review, because some of these just are basically like, is it good or not? And Hamad Shazad and Matthew Iron Reinhardt ask, do you think it's a spiritual sequel to the Sonic 06 review sequel? Basically, Sonic 06 sequel. Basically, in other words, the Sonic the Hedgehog game 2006. Is it a sequel to that? No, because it's not the same game. It's not the same universe. It's a different universe. In other words, it is still buggy, but I'll get into that later on. And basically, that's the questions that's like at the beginning of you. So let's get into the main stuff. The story, the gameplay, the music, the voice acting, and basically the game's quality of visuals. So let's get into that. Story first. I'm going to ask another question that's coming from Zane Birdsong. Is this story any good? I didn't like how the intro was pulled off, and I haven't seen anything past the second fight with the robots. That's her first question. She has 4 questions that I'll be making most of the review. So let's get into the first part of the level. Game. The first level basically the game starts off with a sequence that happens towards the ending of the game where Sonic gets blasted. He's buried under tons of rock, and then it flashes back to a day ago, which is for some reason really surprising, when Sonic and his group of fighters and his group, which is Knuckles, Tails, and Amy, are chasing Eggman to stop him from causing another problem.
What's the matter, Sonic? Can't keep up?
You were saying?
I didn't mean that literally. It was a taunt. It's Villainy 101.
Amy, Knuckles, go left!
Give me a sec.
I'm on it!
And then they encounter Metal Sonic, And basically, Eggman has evil ancient robots that he woke up, and he's using them to kill Sonic's troop when he tries to. But when Sonic and the group have to hide in refuge, they basically go into a hidden lair and close the doors and move some stuff around, and Sonic accidentally awakens an evil enemy named Lyric, a 1,000-year-old reptile who's been in prison for those thousands of years, and basically has a personal vendetta with Sonic.
Guys, can we put a pin in this for a second?
You and I have unfinished business.
I have no idea what you're talking about, but I'm pretty sure it's a bad thing. Now I'm convinced it's a bad thing. Ah!
A 1,000 years later and you're still predictable.
What's he talking about?
He dodged my spin attack. Nobody's ever done that before.
Why? I don't know. He basically has a plan to kill all life form on Earth and then rebuild the world with machine parts. Now, this actually is a cool idea, as the fact that they have injected a new villain into the Sonic series. Is that the same old Eggman wants to make an evil mind-control device to corrupt all humans on Earth? You know? Instead, it's much more unique, but it does go the same as he wants to kill everyone, basically. The story's not the best story ever. It still is serviceable for the game itself. I mean, let's be honest, Sonic story games are never going to be winning Oscars. They never will. So, I don't mind that. However, I do mind that if you're going to have a story, make sure it actually makes sense. For example, why is bringing certain characters for no reason? They bring in Metal Sonic for like a scene or two, then they bring in Shadow the Hedgehog for another scene or two, including a really bad boss fight. It's just really bad. I mean, there's no backstory to some of these characters. Shadow has a grudge with Sonic, but there's no backstory to it. He just shows up, calls Sonic a weak person because he has loyalty to his friends, and then he gets his ass kicked in a boss fight. And then Metal Sonic is just there because Eggman has somehow controls Metal Sonic, and he controls Metal Sonic, tells him what to do, and says go after them and kill them and bring me their bodies so they can destroy them, or something like that. Either way, the story just has story errors or plot errors or something like that. It doesn't really work to itself. Zane Birdsong, so sorry about that. Another question from Zane Birdsong is, also, are the controls tight, and is combat boring? I'm just gonna say this overall. Let's just go into gameplay. Now, combat-wise, the game is kind of diverse. Sonic, basically has a homing attack where you press the X button. Tails has little grenades and a buddy bot that he can use. Knuckles uses his hand because that's what he is, he's Knuckles. And then Amy is basically one who uses her hammer to swing her hammer around and do some awesome beatdowns. Now, I'm fine with the combat, but the problem is the combat has problems, like I said. Basically, is for the fact that you never learn new combos. So, the same combos you use in the beginning of the game is the exact same combos you're going to use at the end of the game, which sucks. Because it never progresses, it never evolves, it just goes tedious and repetitive. And that's the biggest problem with the game, is because you're going to be fighting most of the time in the game. Why? Why doesn't it evolve? Why don't you learn new combos? The thing that they add for variety is a new energy beam, which you get when you basically hold the A button and you swing people around, swing your enemies around like cowboy lassos and you throw them off the map or the level design, which I did most of the time because I didn't bring them. Sometimes I do them as certain objectives or something like that, but that's it. It doesn't really add too much to it. What's really good though is the variety of abilities that each character has. When it comes to platforming and do like exploration. For example, there's blue ramps that Sonic has to hold the X button on to do his like speeding spin dash up the ramp and then do another ramp or stuff like that. Tail uses gusts of wind to do his hover gliding ability. Knuckles can basically do platforming on walls where he puts his knuckles. He basically climbs walls and basically breaks stuff down, and it's specific science for him. And Amy can do triple jumps and platforming and balancing beams that are pink only. That's a great type of diversity, but the problem is that it's not unique enough or good enough for the game to really get out of its own. I don't think I said this at the beginning, but first of all, critics shouldn't be bashing this game in place, alright? Does it deserve perfect praise? No, it doesn't. But does it deserve 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4s? No, it does not deserve those horrible reviews. I know bad games, trust me. So let's get back to the point is that nothing really feels fresh enough or unique enough. And Controls, Zane Birdsong, which is our second question, is not really the best. At times, it doesn't work. At times, it does work. It's like an on and off switch. It pisses me off. It's annoying. Alright, let's get done with the gameplay. Let's continue with the gameplay. Boss fights. I forgot to mention boss fights. Boss fights, like I said, are gonna happen in the game. The first boss fight's kind of repetitive because you're basically punching a guy over and over with his shadow. Then there's an awesome boss fight which goes into speed sections, where speed section then it's a brawl, and then it's objective throwing stuff around, which is with a worm, which is kind of cool. Then there's other boss fights that I won't spoil because I don't want to spoil at all, but let's be honest, some of the boss fights are good, like the worm. But all the other boss fights, they bore me, make me sleepy. I think I'm sleepy from playing it right now. Jesus. And also from the fact that the game mostly focuses on combat, which means that those speed sections that you will get in the game only happen once a level. Maybe twice, if you're lucky. And it's a shame, because those speed sections are the best. But the problem is their goddamn frame rate can't even keep up with it, which is so annoying. And bad. For love of God, if you're gonna make a game, make sure the frame rate is actually solid. At least. Seriously. Next question is, how bad are the glitches in the game in all seriousness? I've seen a few small things before, and I'm wondering how often these things occur, these glitches. Alright, Zane, this is the thing. This game is buggy as hell. It's like a buggy disaster glitch. There is glitches that are so annoying that some people say it's game-breaking. Seriously. There is even a glitch in the game where you can beat the game in an hour, which means it has no real reason to be played. You can beat the game in an hour with Knuckles, which I believe. Which is kind of freaking stupid. It's just disappointing. It doesn't even just live with that. There's big pop-in textures. There's big problem with draw distances. Animations, it is weird. Slip syncing is horrible. Seriously? Come on. Not only that, there's problem with the glitches of animation NPC characters. And basically parts where characters just fall to the ground at some points, or some platforms are supposed to be there, aren't there. It just feels like the game was rushed out to day one. And it's a shame because the game uses a Cry engine, which is a crisis engine, basically. And there's maybe two reasons why this, what's wrong here. Either the Wii U can't handle the Cry engine, or the developers have no way in hell how to use it. And I believe the developers have no way in hell how to use it. I don't think the Nintendo Wii can actually handle it. But maybe in a better game than this. Seriously. It's the bugs in this game is unbelievable. And not only that, if you play co-op mode with a buddy or a brother or a family member, the glitches get worse. If you and your buddy try to go in different areas, the game will just push you together at the exact same screen, causing glitches to try to escape. No, it just pushes you together. There's major screen tearing. There's major knitting problems here and there. And some just dirty spots. But Sonic's character and all the other team members' characters are great, and so is Eggman. They're fine.
Can't get much higher than what I talk about this game.
Jesus, I need to stop. Anyways, it just loses its fun, and its quality definitely falls short of a good Wii U title. It's this disappointing. Next question. The game looks like a PS3 game. That's not bad, but not what it should be, I guess. I don't know. I just think the game overall is just not in good quality. It feels unpolished and unfinished in terms of graphical quality and gameplay. It feels like they just rushed it out. That's all of Zane's questions, just to let you know. Next person asks questions is Simon Elskin Peterson. Is it worth getting the Wii U for? Is it good for a casual Sonic fan for pure nostalgia, or is it actually worth picking up? Is it worth picking up at full price? First question is, it's not worth getting the Wii U for at all, seriously, in my personal opinion. I don't really think it's worth getting a Wii U for. There's no bundle coming out for the Wii U in this. Seriously, I don't think there's a chance in hell. Number two question, is it good for a pickup Sonic fan? Not really. I mean, this is made for new fans. But more importantly, this game is made for little kitties, for those 7-year-olds or those 10-year-olds. Which means that some grandparents are going to buy this thing for their kids. And I don't think it's for casual Sonic fans. This is made for a new audience. But the audience they're reaching for is mostly for kids. Seriously. And is it worth picking up full price? The game is actually priced at $50. But I don't think it's worth it. I think it's worth that $30 max. Basically, $30. So wait for a price drop for that. And then maybe it's worth picking up at that type of rate. Chase Sorkin also asks, why are Sonic games sold on the fact that you can run super fast, but then they punish you for trying to go fast? Well, because in Sonic games, speed is a reward in a Sonic game. And in this, it's not really a reward. It's, I mean, because when you go in speed, when you go fast in those speeding moments, it punishes you because of the goddamn frame rate. The game moves in slow motion at times. It's unbelievable. And this is disappointing overall. It's just, like, too much to talk about here, okay? Okay. I think I said enough about this game already. I think after everything I said, I think you guys know what type of game this is. So let's just get this over with. The music is fine, but it's put at the worst parts of the game. Voice acting is top notch from the TV show actors. Like, Sonic is good as always. Tails is good, Knuckles is good, Amy's good, and Dr. Eggman's good. Everyone else is kind of passable, except Larry. He's fine. Music, I said, is fine. Gameplay gets repetitive way too quickly, even with the awesome platforming at times, which is fine. It's just, the game just doesn't feel like it's fully complete, and that's the biggest problem. There's even a 4-player challenge mode, but I didn't play it again after one round. I mean, I got bored of it real quickly. So it's time now for the final word. You know, I would be giving it crappiness if I was a bitchy critic. But I'm not that. So I'm going to give it a final verdict of a 5.5 out of 10. It's average. It's average at best. And it's batshit horrible at its worst. In my personal opinion, this game was not worth picking up at $50. It's possibly worth picking up at $20 or $30 max. And I'm a huge fan of the Sonic franchise, and it hurts me just to say it. You know, if you want a good Sonic game, go get Sonic Colors, Sonic Generations, or some other Sonic games that were good. You know? Hell, pick up Sonic Unleashed. You might get some fun out of that game, you know? Just not this. If Big Red Button Entertainment gets another chance, I hope they can improve on all the flaws here and not enhance the flaws. Please don't enhance it. Please. Just try to make a good game next time. And maybe if that game is good, I will scream at the mountaintops. I would post online stuff saying, buy that game if it was good. But today is not that game. Not that day. I hope someday in the future, there will be a Sonic game that gets all the right marks. But for right now, Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric is not one of them. That's it for the review, guys. Okay? If you like this video, please do. Also, comment below with your personal opinions about the game and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Michael Martinez is Michael Martinez is on Facebook. Twitter is TheMichaelEntertainer7. If this is a Sonic game in the future that does not improve any of these problems, or it's just the same old thing we've been getting throughout the years, I may lose faith in the Sonic franchise, and that hurts me to say it. So until then, I'll see you guys on the next episode of The Michael M. 1997.